subtle rush of panic. These surroundings were too familiar. I don't have time to know the subtle differences between the painkillers. The big picture was untimely. It only revealed itself after I put it together using the pieces of my psyche. Repressed memories I keep locked in a head case. I don't like how the medicine tastes. Keep the pace at my heart's rate, but slow down once the sedative takes. How does this jacket keep anything straight? No time for questions. In these help yourself self-help group sessions, I don't have anything left to give except a few confessions that I scribble down in the notepad. But it won't take you too long for you to know that I'd rather keep to myself. And who better knows that than me and not anyone else? Tied down in professional help, clenched fists and weather flaps, pulling at my wrist and these leather straps, clipboards and his head shrinking white coats. No self-esteem, but they heard he had high hopes. They don't know what they're gonna find when they poke inside. So the physician decides to prescribe little white lies that'll keep them all quiet for now until the side effects start to wear them down. They say the money's in the medicine, but when their funding is up, I guess that's when he's shit out of luck. Longer preventable, so he does his best to try and hide them. But the more that he tries, the more that he finds these times of trying. So he gives in to outbursts of outrageous violence until his frustrations are subsided and it's uncontrollable laughter. They lock him away in a cold room and it starts building away. He had the paint pieces of plaster. He's been there before and he knows it won't be his last. Getting the same outcome every time is comparable to simple math. They analyze his behavior and the way that he interacts. He has a profound outlook, but the physical vision lacks. That's when he closes his eyes and draws a perfect circle freehanded. And there's no way that you could ever understand it. That's when you feel done in, feeling ashamed to call yourself normal with all of the circles that you try and run in. So they keep him quarantined away from everything. It's unsettling, something that they've never seen. He knows his condition and all of his vital signs are stable. Heart rate normal, lying on the operating table. They run multiple tests trying to examine his internal organs and find them in the medical journals. And then for the first time in years, he finally speaks another something so beautiful that everyone in the room weeps. He gets up when he's finished. They have the satisfaction of knowing the answer, but now they all have to live with it.